Hello friends, welcome to my channel. You can search my all educational videos for standard 9 and 10 by searching Pravinesh Publication on YouTube. If you have any doubt, then you can contact me on my number, that is 9016487991. You can ask me any question on this number. This is a WhatsApp number, so you can contact. Today we start chapter number 12, Electricity. This is physics chapter. This chapter contains some theory, some derivations and numericals. So let us understand this chapter in topic 1. I'll ask you first question. What is electricity? Have you seen electricity? So somebody will say, yes sir, we have seen electricity. So I'll ask a counter question. What is the color of the electricity? Somebody will say that is white color. Somebody will say that is yellow color, red color, green color. Somebody will say, sir, we have seen the light, that is green color, white color, different color. But that is not true. We cannot see electricity because this is not a physical phenomena. We can only feel the electricity. For example, if I ask you a question, have you seen fear? No, we have not seen fear, but we have feel the fear. So same way, electricity cannot be seen. It is not a physical phenomena. Now, what is the definition of electricity? Simple definition of electricity is flow of free electrons in metals. We know that metals are a good conductor of electricity. For example, if we take sodium, so its electronic configuration is 281. So it has one free electrons which can move inside the metal but cannot go outside the metal. So the movement of free electrons or the flow of free electrons is known as electricity. This is a one kind of energy. Now, as I explained, metals, they have a free electrons. The free electrons are continuously moving, so they conduct electricity. For example, this is the electron. It has negative charge. In any metal, if it is moving in this direction, so we got electricity energy, that is electrical energy, in opposite direction. Understood this again? If electrons are moving in right direction, we get energy, that is electrical energy, in opposite direction. Now, for example, this is any cross section of a metal. That means a piece of metal. If you touch any metal object, can you feel electricity? The answer is no. Why no? I'll explain. For example, this is one electron which is moving in this direction. This is another electron which is moving in this direction. They can move in random direction. This is another electron which move in this direction. So we got energy in the opposite direction, that is electrical energy. So at the same time, another electron will move in this direction, another electron will move in this direction, and they cancel each other's charge. So no net movement of electrons we feel. So that we do not feel any electricity by touching a metal object. So what we do to get electricity? The simple way, this all electrons will move in the same direction. If they move in the same direction, we get electricity in the opposite direction. So this is the answer, that electrons should move in the same direction. Now how we can give movement to electrons so that they can move in the same direction? The simple answer is by applying a cell or a battery in electric circuit. Now, what is electric circuit? I'll draw simple electric circuit on the board. For example, this is any conducting wire which is made up of copper, aluminium, etc. This is a bulb. This is the curly line I have drawn, that is the filament of a bulb. The filament of a bulb is made up of tungsten. Why it is made up of tungsten? That is due to two reasons. First reason, it has high melting point. And second reason, do not oxidize at high temperature. So due to these two reasons, we are using tungsten as a filament of a bulb. Now I'll complete the simple electric circuit. This is a larger line and smaller line which represent a cell. The larger line is positive terminal and the smaller line is a negative terminal. Then after a key, that is a plug key. So when we switch on, what happens? The electrons are present at the negative electrode. They are tremendously moving inside this electrical circuit. They will enter into the bulb filament and due to friction, they will generate large amount of heat. This bulb, it has some gases filled in it, for example helium, argon, neon, etc. These gases have a characteristics to glow while they capture heat. Now when electrons lose energy, they will move on this path, again they will enter into the battery and again they will capture the energy and they move tremendously inside the circuit. As I said, the direction of electricity is the opposite direction of electrons. So this is the direction of electrons. They are moving from negative terminal to the positive terminal of the battery. So electricity will flow from positive terminal to negative terminal of the battery. Here I have shown two arrows which shows the direction of electricity. So this is simple electrical circuit. Now we move on the next topic of the textbook. Friends, you can download the textbook on your mobile, that is online, which is easily available. If you do not have a physical copy of the textbook, then you can download on your phone with the Google applications. Now next topic is electric current. Symbolically it is represented by I. Now first formula of this chapter, I is equals to Q upon T. So this is the first formula of your chapter. Friends, the formula are very important. They are useful for the numericals. So try to memorize from now. I, that is electric current. Q, that is electric charge present on an electron. How much charge present on an electron? Electrons contain negative 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. So this is a unit of electric charge, that is coulomb, that is C, T, that is time. Now I'll write the unit. What is the unit of electric current? Ampere. So 1 ampere is equals to 1 coulomb upon 1 second. Now there are two definitions. First definition is of the electric current, that can be explained by this formula. And the second definition is the defined unit of current or defined 1 ampere. First I'll say the definition of current. What is the definition of current? The amount of electric charge flowing through the cross section of a metal in unit time is known as electric current. Second, defined unit of current or defined 1 ampere. If 1 coulomb of charge flowing through a cross section of a material in 1 second, then amount of electric current is said to be 1 ampere. So these are two definitions you have to memorize. I will send the worksheets on your mobile if you demand. Now this is the large unit of current. We can write 1 ampere is equals to 10 raised to 3 milliampere. This is a smaller unit of current. Again, 1 ampere is equals to 10 raised to 6 microampere. So these are 2, milliampere and microampere are the small unit. By which instrument we can measure the electric current? In electric circuit, that is via ammeter. Ammeter is a device which can symbolically express by A, N plus, N minus. With the help of this device, we can measure the electric current in a circuit. Now, next topic, that is electric potential difference. Friends, numerical we will do in the later sections. That is, I'll make the personal topic for the numerical. Right now, we do all the theory. Electric potential difference. Friends, you have heard about this word potential in 9th standard, correct? There are two types of energy, kinetic energy and potential energy. So, this is the same way here we are using the word electric potential. Before understanding this, I'll give you one example. Suppose you want to move this pen from one place to another place. What you need to apply? You need to apply energy. You need to apply force so that this pen can move from one place to another place. Same way again. I'll draw simple electric circuit. Here, we need energy from the bulb. We need light from the bulb. For that, what we need to do? Simple. Electron should move in this circuit. So here, electrons, they need energy. So this energy, they utilize and move in this circuit and we get the energy from the bulb. So first, electron needs to move, let us point A and then after point B. Now, I'll say the definition of electric potential. The amount of energy required by a particle to move from one point to another point. Here, in the context of chapter electricity, we use the word electrons. So, the amount of energy required by the electron to move from one point to infinity. Here you say, sir, why you use the word infinity? Because electrons are very minute. So, even distance between two dots, if I do two dots, these two dots, so this distance is called infinity for the electrons. Now, here we come back to our topic. Electron needs to be moved first to point A, then after to point B. So, the amount of energy required by the electron to move the point A is said to be VA. So, potential at point A is VA and the potential at B is VB. Again, amount of energy required by the electron to move a point A, that is VA, into point B is VB. Which point required larger energy? So, obviously, it is VB. So, we can write VB is greater than VA. So, electricity will flow from point B to point A. This is called electric potential difference. Friends, you have seen the pencil cell. In pencil cell, there is a written plus and minus. So, this is a positive electrode and this is a negative electrode. And this is a pencil cell contains 1.5 V something written. So, this is a unit of electric potential difference, that is volt. And the difference between these two electrodes is 1.5 volt. Now, I will write the formula. Second formula, V is equals to W upon Q. Here, V, that is potential difference. W, that is work done, that is energy, and Q, that is electric charge. So, I'll write the unit, 1 volt is equals to 1 joule per 1 coulomb. Now, definition of 1 volt, define 1 volt. If 1 joule of work is done over a 1 coulomb of charge, then amount of electric potential is said to be 1 volt. How can we measure the electric potential in a circuit? So that is with the help of instrument voltmeter. With the help of voltmeter, we can measure the electric potential of the circuit. So, today I'll explain two topics. One is the electricity and second one is electric potential difference. Friends, read from the textbook. Any doubt, again, you can ask me on my number, that is WhatsApp number 9016487991. If you like this video, then please subscribe it. press the bell icon so you will get the updates, and share to other students so other students can also study online. Thank you.